Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to show you my trash. So, I don't know why, but this is probably one of my favorite videos to film, is sitting here showing you things that are going to go in the garbage. But anyway, these are products that I've used up this last month for August. Wow. September already. And we had a really nice, cool fall day today. It was so nice. Anyway, so I don't have a whole lot, but enough to sit here probably for a good 15-20 minutes, so we'll get started. Of course, the first thing, y'all are probably, if y'all watch these every month, you're sick and tired of seeing these, but these are my makeup remover wipes that I use every morning when I'm getting ready for work. Buy those at Big Lots and we'll definitely repurchase those. Matter of fact, I think I'm on my last bag, so I'm gonna have to go to Big Lots and make a purchase. Then I have some vitamins. These are the Ollie probiotic vitamins. These are good to help keep your tummy in good health. I highly recommend these. These are gummies. They taste good. The first time that I purchased them, I got them at Target, but then I went on to the Ollie website and you can get them a little cheaper if you buy them, if you get on their auto delivery. So that's what I do with those. Then I have a couple of Epsom salts. I have the Dr. Teal's Pink Himalayan Mineral Soak. Highly recommend this. It smells so good. It will leave your bathroom smelling good. It will leave you smelling good. It has pink Himalayan salt and bergamot and sweet orange in it, and it just, oh, it smells so good. Definitely, I wish they sold those in bigger bags. Anyway, this one I didn't care for that much. This was from Target. It's the Up and Up brand, and it was the lavender scent. I didn't really care for it, so I don't know if it was just because it was lavender. I haven't tried the lavender and the Dr. Teal's, so I don't know if there's a difference, but I didn't like that one, so I'm not going to repurchase that one. I have a deodorant, my clinical degree, clinical protection. I'm a sweaty girl, and I have to have maximum protection, so I use that. A cleanser from MAC. This is the Cleanse Off Oil from MAC. And I probably won't be repurchasing these anytime soon because I have like a huge bottle of the Pure Philosophy Purity Made Simple that I need to get through. So anyway, but I do recommend that as far as a cleanse off oil. I think that one and the one that's Sephora, that is their house brand, is probably the best that I have tried. Then I have a essence that I finished. This is the Cremore Lab Essence, and it was a mineral treatment essence. I ordered this off of Peach and Lily back during the Cyber Monday, Black Friday deals that were going on. I won't repurchase it. I just like the May Coupe Raw Sauce a lot better as far as the essence go. And plus, I didn't really care for the smell of this. This really smelled, it smelled like dirt. It was very earthy, very, very earthy smelling. And I just didn't care for it, but I did use it. I have a little baby Ole Henriksen Truth Serum, the vitamin C. I used this the week that I was out in Vegas. And I do like this. I don't need to purchase this though because I have a vitamin C full bottle from Drunk Elephant that I need to use first. And I think probably after that I'm going to go back to my Philosophy vitamin C powder where you mix it fresh every day. I think that's a better choice for my skin. Oh. This was so sad that this is gone. This is my Mango Factory Rose Hip Oil Mist. It's a Rose Hip Essence Balancing Mist. I use every morning after I put on all of my makeup and my powders. I would just put this all over the face, spritz it. Oh, I wish that would focus. Come on, guy, focus. And I recommend this stuff. hands down. This is my favorite face mist. Smells wonderful. Smells like roses. I love it. I'm definitely going to order another one. But I'm going to make myself finish and use my MAC. Oh, what is that thing called? You know what I'm talking about. Everybody talks about Prep and Prime. Is it the Prep and Prime? I don't even know what it is. I don't really like it, but I'm going to make myself use that, and then I'm going to buy 3 bottles of this, so I have it. I love that. On the other hand, I did finish this. This is the Wonder Glow Getter Mist. It is a glacier water, rose spray. It was in a kit. I didn't really care for this. It was okay, but I definitely like the other one a whole lot better than this one. So, anyway, won't be buying that. While I was on, while I was in Vegas, I also finished up this little bottle of the Cinema Secret Makeup Brush Cleaner. I love this stuff. I buy it in the big bottle most generally. I am pretty sure that this was either a 100 point perk, or it was one that you could get if you put in a code when you made a purchase. But anyway, great for travel, this little bottle. Definitely recommend. Yes. I finished up a deluxe size sample of the YSL Chusha Clot Blur Primer. I didn't really care for this. I'm just not a big silicone person as far as primer goes. I love to have some silicone in my boobs, but I don't like it on my face. So definitely wouldn't repurchase or purchase the big size of it just because of the silicone in there. Anyway, another product from The Ordinary that I finished. This is The Ordinary, the buffet. The Ordinary has a ton of skincare to choose from, and if you're a little bit confused on where to start, what to get, this is a good one to start with because it has a little bit of everything in it, hence the word the buffet. It's definitely a good serum. I do recommend The Ordinary. And I don't know if that's going to focus or not, but anyway, it was called The Buffet. I think it was around, $6, $9. I mean, it's so inexpensive for that brand. I mean, you can purchase it off of Beautylish now. Last, I have a little deluxe size sample of a eyeliner. This is the Lorac Professional. What is this called? I can't read it without my glasses. But anyway, it was just a little deluxe eye sample. I didn't really care for it. It was okay as long as you didn't put it on your waterline. If you try to tight line with it when you would blink, then you would get a white line here under your eyes, on the inner rim of your eyes. So, but as far as being just on top of the eyelid, it was fine. But I'm just not going to run out and purchase the full size of it. Finished up this little guy. This was sent to me for review a while back through Octoly, and this is called the Lab Grab. I call it gel mask, and I used that all up. This was really nice. I really did enjoy this mask. I think I talked about it not only in that original haul video, PR haul video, but I also included it in one of my masking videos. So. Expensive, but I think it's worth the price on it. So, and this is from Silk Therapeutics, is the brand of that. Have some little exfoliating cloths, not cloths, cotton rounds from Ulta, the Ulta brand. This is probably one of my favorite brands of exfoliating cotton pads, so I do recommend those. Now we have some mascaras to talk about. So first of all is the Tightline mascara from It Cosmetics. Wasn't a huge fan of it, and as I was trying to use it and everything, my brush got all wonky. See how it's curved? So I went and repurchased it. I may have even talked about this in a favorite, but I don't think it really was worth having a separate mascara just for your tight line. So I'm over it. I had a little baby size of the YSL The Shock mascara. This was pretty good. I don't know if I would want to spend that price tag on it, but the brush was pretty nice. Wasn't too pokey, and it really helped with creating volume but not length. This used to be my Holy Grail mascara, and this is the Mally Volumizing Mascara. If you are the type of person that doesn't like to open up a mascara and it be wet and then you have to wait for it to kind of dry out a little bit before it really, really works good, get this, because this right out of the get-go is a little bit of a drier formula, and it does volumize. Works really well. I had ordered a whole bunch of these from QVC. It used to be on auto delivery with QVC with these. You can get them at Ulta now though, but at last I am over my love affair with this. Just like everything else, beauty wise, you know, we love something for a while and then we move on and in love with something else. We're so fickle when it comes with our beauty products. But anyway, this little product here, this was from Chanel. At one time, I would have probably sat here and told you how wonderful it was. But since I've tried the L'Oreal eyelash primer in this, no, don't waste your money on it. But it was just an eyelash primer from Chanel. Not worth the money. Go to Walmart, go to Walgreens, go to CVS, go to Target, wherever, and get the L'Oreal eyelash primer. It's hands down the best eyelash primer on the market, and it's cheap. This is probably my new favorite mascara of life for now, for today, maybe tomorrow. What am I using now? Oh yeah, what I'm using now is okay. Anyway, this is the It Cosmetics Superhero mascara. This is a really good mascara. I really do enjoy this mascara. Used it till the very, very end. I mean, it was getting so goopy and so hard to work with, and every time I would use it and then shut my lid, you can see all the stuff that would kind of squish out. I'd always have to clean that, but I used it as long as I could, longer than the 3 months. I know that. Not much of a stickler when it comes to replacing your mascara every 3 months. I'm more like use a mascara until you're like going like this to it, you know, and trying to get it on. I'm more like that kind. So anyway, guys, that's it for my empties. Well, of course, except for all of my mask, but I'm going to do that in a separate video so that I can have more time to talk about those. So anyway, thank you so much for joining me today with my trash, my garbage. I hope that you will be so inclined to give me a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button if you're not already subscribed. Also, if you are subscribed, hit the little bell icon so that you're notified of any upcoming and future videos that I may present to you in the future. Anyway, thank you so much. Talk to you soon. Bye.